Hello, I am Ed Drewett and you are watching Cazfest TV.
I'm trying to keep these to a minimum.
Yes.
Because obviously I have to sing later.
Yep.
It's a long old day to try and, you know, to be in a festival and not drink.
Yes.
I'm doing all right.
Good.
I'm doing all right, Michaela. It's fine.
Excellent stuff. So I want to talk to you a little bit first about your songwriting, because obviously you've written for some pretty impressive...
Somehow.
One Direction, The Wanted, Olly Murs.
Yeah.
How did you get into doing that?
God knows. well, initially I signed a record deal in 2009 for my own stuff.
Right.
And then unfortunately the label I was at, it was all a bit of a mess. So I had these songs lying around and I gave a song to The Wanted, and that was their first single, All Time Low. How do you get up from an all time low? And you know, and then for me that sparked off other writing opportunities, you know, yeah. Writing more songs for them, Glad You Came, whatever, and that became the start of my songwriting story, journey.
Fantastic.
Career, you know, so
yeah, pretty big break, and obviously the
awesome.
Wanted tracks have gone.
The Wanted
out of...
tracks were mad, and then you know, obviously Olly and 1D.
And how was that sort of like hearing your songs?
It's really bizarre.
On the radio and on the telly, and
yeah, really weird. People say, oh, do you not get jealous that it's not you singing it? And obviously, there's always a part of me that wants to be singing them.
Yeah,
but you can't knock that feeling.
No.
Not going to hear a song that I wrote on the radio and be like, ah,
yeah,
really
absolutely,
angry.
Absolutely.
You're going to be like, yeah, that's sick. Dear darling, please excuse my writing. I can stop my hands from shaking. Cause I'm cold,
yeah,
and
sick.
I don't.
Yeah,
so,
completely.
So it's,
and when you sort of write your songs, obviously writers write in different ways.
Yeah.
How do you start out writing a song?
I normally start on piano or bass and just freestyle some melodies over it. So I'll get the chords, freestyle melodies, and then I'll mumble words, and then some of them will sound like real words.
Yep. And then you'll pick the words
and
out
then
I'll
pick and the words
take
and then I'll go, oh, okay, cool. And that might spark me off on a story, or I have a concept set aside and start writing from a concept.
Yeah, fantastic.
Yeah.
Great stuff.
And it seems to work.
Yes.
I'm not going to change
it. No, anything. Obviously it's working very well. So obviously you then went on Britain's Got Talent. You said you always liked me more. I'm sad and angry, leaving pencils by your door. Go draw me a smiley face, sharpen up your feelings, babe. Write with me just one more line and say you're on my side. I'm on the fire.
Unfortunately, I mean, you know, it didn't work out the way we planned it, the way we wanted it to, but I think that was an interesting move, I think, because I'd been through two kind of useless record labels.
Okay.
They were going through a lot of changes. So I'd been dropped from two record labels over 3.5 years, tried to release independently, and had no support from radio.
Yep.
So then I'm like, what more can I do?
Yeah.
You know, what more can I do? So I gave it a go, and, you know, semi-finals is cool.
Pretty good,
it didn't give me the springboard for me to release my stuff, you know, fully.
But I saw an interview with you not that long ago. It said you were starting your own record label. Is that accurate?
Well, what I want to do now is, I mean, don't tell anyone, but what I want to do is kind of put the solo thing on hold. I think sometimes you can go for something, you know, and have all that passion and drive trying to get something. But at the end of the day, I think there's a time to also be a little bit clever about it and be like, well, you've kind of exhausted all avenues now. Stop wasting time and like try and put your effort into something else. I'm going to start a band, I reckon.
Okay.
I'm going to disappear to LA for a couple of months.
Fantastic.
Come back. No Twitter, no Facebook.
Okay. That'll be hard,
no
I'm
people.
Sure.
It will.
And what sort of music will that be, do you reckon? Have you got something
in
mind?
It's going to be a little more organic, a little more... I don't know, do you like the Eagles, the Police?
Yes, in fact...
Sorry, I keep touching
your legs. That's all right, that's fine.
It's not intentional.
um,
We were actually listening to some of your music, and I also watched an interview where you said that those guys were like some of your inspirations.
They
and
are,
I actually thought that your voice would be really well suited to that kind of music. I think that's a great avenue for you to pursue personally, in
you.
My humble opinion.
Thank you very much. Well, I think what I can't ignore is that through all the songwriting I've done for other people, there's always been this kind of little underlying thread of a sound that feels like it's me.
Yeah.
And I think now is a good time to wave, you know, adieu to my older stuff and kind of just freshen it up a bit. Come
Absolutely.
Back with something a bit fresh.
Great.
Front man of band.
Yeah, fantastic. That sounds good. I look forward to it. And are you writing anything for anyone else at the moment?
I am.
Will you be?
We've just been working on some of the One Direction. And we danced all night to the best song ever. We knew every line. Now I can't remember how it goes, but I know that I won't forget her.
They're big pop songs, the 1D songs, aren't they?
They are. Did you hear any of the did you hear the album? The last album.
I haven't heard the whole album, but I've heard obviously the ones that were singles.
People honestly were completely shocked at some of the tunes on there. The quality of the tunes. I'm not even saying stuff that I wrote, but stuff that two of my best friends wrote, John and Julian, and other great writers on there. Incredible songs, rock songs that you could have heard the Stones do. You know, legit incredible music.
Yeah.
And people were like, oh, this is weird. It's One Direction and it's really good.
Yeah.
you know, so it would be great to get some more tracks on there.
Yeah.
The new album.
Fantastic. Yeah, we look forward to watching your performance.
Sweet.
Yes.
I'm so nervous, man. I'm like, I haven't performed properly for a while, and I'm like, I need to stop drinking beer because I'm going to be all wavy.
Yes, it's never the best idea, is it? This is what happens when you arrive too early, I reckon. You know.
You should have arrived 10 minutes before, straight on stage.
Good morning. We never said goodnight. Into our dreams without saying goodbye. Good morning. Let's forget you cried. Sunlight ain't sleeping now, neither should I. One good morning, and not a moment wasted. Give me just a minute and everything changes. Oh, how can I be mad at such innocent faces? I can make it good when it's bad in your eyes.
Guys, it's very important that all of you donate towards Cazfest. It's for cardiac risk in the young, and you can do that at www.cazfest.com.
Damn, I nearly did it.